Okay, so today we have Foo Fighters, The Pretender. I do want to also say my lips are still a little messed up. I do have a fever blister, but we're gonna roll on here because I wanted to do a thing for Taylor Hawkins here, drummer of the Foo Fighters, obviously. Passed away a few days ago as I record this. I think it was on March 25th of 2022, and at the age of 50, suddenly, like an hour before Foo Fighters were scheduled to go on stage in Colombia, I think it was. And so obviously, that it's just so sudden. I mean, tragic. I mean, for the rock community, for the music community, everybody, so many tributes came out from so many artists and actors and people that Taylor touched. So I just wanted to do this kind of a review thing, which is what I like to do when something like this happens. Somebody that I like passes away, I want to do a review or something. So here we go with this. Foo Fighters, The Pretender, one of my favorite Foo Fighters songs. So let's get into it and talk about it after. Also, one of my favorite Foo Fighters songs because of Taylor. So yeah, let's go. Turn it up.
What if I say that I'll never surrender?
All right. So the Foo Fighters and the Pretender. So like I said, probably my favorite Foo Fighters song. I would have to say it was one of the, it was the first song that kind of made me, I guess, a fan of the Foo Fighters, coming from Nirvana, obviously, with as a teen listening to Nirvana and then being like, oh, this is what Dave did next with the Foo Fighters. And obviously Taylor Hawkins joining later, I want to say in 1999 or something around there when he joined, or 98. Either way, yeah, it's just, and so I just really enjoy this. Obviously, also, like I said, mostly because of Taylor. I just with the continuous, the striking that he comes into at the start, just like the one thing is just like the. And I was just like, I don't know what it was just infectious. And then how he breaks it down, like a minute in, and I don't know, just so much power behind his drumming, obviously. And obviously he had so much grace with drumming. I would say, coming from, I mean, I would say one of, if not the best, modern rock drummer, modern drummer of today. And it's just he had so much talent. And I mean, you look back to. I know that he would tour with Alanis Morissette, or Alanis, or I think it's Alanis. Anyway, Morissette, and for her, I remember they performed live on Letterman in 1995, want to say, and he was a drummer. Drumming for a long time. Obviously, he had his own band. I know that as well. And more than that, just like just watching him in interviews again, usually with Dave Grohl, talking about their influences, talking about just whatever, the band. They just seem like, obviously Dave is he's become, he's known, I guess, as, one of the nicest guys in rock. And Taylor as well was just he was also so nice and funny. And I mean, I know that he loved bands, a lot of bands that I love. I know that he loved Oasis and obviously he loved Rush, and Queen. I know I think they inducted both Queen and Rush into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Dave and Taylor did, I think. But also, yeah, so like Oasis, and I know the Beach Boys as well. I know for Dennis Wilson's album, Pacific Ocean Blue from 1977, I know that he did vocals for a track that was not finished or something like that. And I know Brian Wilson tweeted about it yesterday or something like that. And just talked about that as well, just about how much, how much he loved the Beach Boys. So all this stuff just coming out about that, and I know that also Taylor said that. Liam Gallagher, who I love again as a big fan of Oasis and a big fan of Liam Gallagher, he said, that Liam Gallagher was like the best, rock and roll front man of today or something like that. He said, anyway, so all this stuff is just like I can imagine, if I ever had a chance to talk with Taylor Hawkins, it would have been very nice, because we had a lot of the same interests and also the Cars. I know that he really enjoyed the Cars, and he collaborated with Elliot Easton, at least live, I remember seeing a couple times. So yeah, again, just all this stuff just coming out, and I'm just like, good Lord, what a nice guy. All these videos, tributes, whatever, people coming out, musicians, like I said, just talking about Taylor Hawkins, and just again the energy, just the happiness he showed for drumming. He just, I mean, obviously he was very good at it, and it just showed through, the passion he had, and just how powerful he was, and how such a heavy hitter you would say. So yeah, but also I just wanted to give a little bit of I guess information about the song here, The Pretender, because again I guess I've never delved into the song, but I've listened to it a lot, but I've never actually looked at the lyrics. But here, on Genius, like usually I'm on Genius here, there's an about. So it says the Pretender was a late addition to the Foo Fighters' sixth album. Holy moly! But once recorded, soon started growing in importance, becoming the lead single off of Echo, Silence, Patience, and Grace, and a mainstay of the band's concerts. Excuse me. All of a sudden, I have a burp. Anyway, it says the Foo Fighters on the lyrics. So I don't know what part of the band, but just as Foo Fighters on the lyrics, you're on Genius. It says, that's the thing with lyrics. You never want to give away specifics, because it's nice for people to have their own idea about interpretation of the song. But everyone's been effed over before, and I think a lot of people feel effed over right now, and they're not getting what they were promised, and so something to do with that. So I think that's a Dave Grohl quote, because also on Song Facts here, he did say in a radio station interview, it says, he says he alluded to the fact that the song referred to political unrest and people not getting what they were promised, but then he also said he would prefer people to have their own idea or interpretation. And that's just, you know, that's what I like about, you know, Dave, I guess. And I like, you know, it's those kind of songs where it's just like, again, we're talking about Oasis there earlier because I brought it up because I know Taylor loved them. The song, like, you know, Champagne Supernova from Oasis, you know, I remember Noel Gallagher saying, you know, there's a quote that he said. It was just like, you know, a lyric like slowly walking down the hall faster than a cannonball. It's like, what the hell does that mean? And he said he doesn't even know what it means because when he wrote it, he was high or something like that. But he said it, but when, you know, 50,000 people are singing it back to you at a concert, it means something different to each and every one of them. And that's what, I mean, that's what music seems to be really about. That's what it is about. It's just like, you know, interpretation. It's just like relate, you know, being relatable. It's just like one person will take the song this way, but another will take it this way. And, you know, it'll help them in their life this way. And, you know, it's just like, it'll help them, you know, not be, you know, not be depressed or whatever. And a song like this, as it says here, Dave Grohl has also described the song to Billboard magazine. He said, a stomping Foo Fighters up-tempo song, obviously up-tempo, yes, with a little bit of Chuck Berry in it. So I like that as well. But yeah, just like that whole thing about being relatable, being up-tempo again, and just being, you know, if you're down and out, listening to a song like this, it's just like, oh God, I'm back in it. And just really enjoy that. And again, Taylor Hawkins' drums, it's just like, again, I'm sure there's other Foo Fighters songs where, you know, he shows his proficiency, and he shows, you know, his chops a lot more or whatever. But as well, you know, one of the first Foo Fighters songs that I heard, I was just like, oh, that drumming just gets me going. And come to find out it was Taylor Hawkins. So yeah, just really, you know, I mean, again, just his death was just so sudden. It's just like, I remember, because like I said at the start of the video, you know, I had a fever blister going on here, but on Friday night, I think it was Friday, anyway, the 25th, anyway. And then I think Foo Fighters on their Facebook and Instagram, they put it up at like 12 a.m., like March 26th, it would have been then. But I saw that and I was like in bed sick, and I just, you know, I just honestly, I was throwing up or whatever, or like 5 minutes before. And I looked and I was just like, Taylor Hawkins passed away. I was just like, what the heck is this? And then, you know, going on and you see all these tributes, and it's just like, what? I was just, you know, taken aback. And I was just like, you know, because again, it's just so sudden. Again, he's 50 years old. I mean, I didn't, you know, it's just, you know, I never saw anything about, you know, this was going to happen. Obviously, nobody knew that this was going to happen. And again, they were scheduled to perform like an hour before it was, you know, released, or an hour before it was announced that he passed away. And it's just like, what the hell? It's just like, holy, like I don't even, you know, you don't even know what to say. And honestly, you think about like his wife and his two kids, you know, his two young kids as well. I mean, they just lost their dad. His wife just lost her husband. I mean, still just 50 years old. And I mean, they still had so much, I mean, obviously, many more years to give. Taylor did at least, you know, like 30 more years or whatever to be like 80 years old, you know, watch his kids grow up and, you know, all that other stuff, grow old. And, yeah, so but I do have to say, really, you know, the Foo Fighters were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 2021. So I'm glad that he was there for that. Obviously, that comes to mind. But yeah, just such a sad and sudden death. It's just, it was a death that I didn't expect that would happen at all. You know, Taylor Hawkins of the Foo Fighters. It's just, and I don't know what the band does now. I mean, I don't know if they'll get another drummer. I don't know what, I mean, they might go on hiatus, you would think. But again, and then you think about it in Dave Grohl's perspective. I mean, obviously losing Kurt Cobain in 1994, and then I do know that there was, you know, rumors that like the band might have stopped anyway, even if Kurt didn't pass away, but they might have like been done. But anyway, yeah, obviously with Kurt passing away, you know, and you're the drummer, and then your drummer, and you're the, and then when you create your own band as the front man, and then your drummer passes away, not only your drummer, but like your best friend since Kurt, basically, you know, you lose two of your bestest friends. And I mean, I remember, you know, an interview, like I said, I've watched, you know, since Taylor passed away, I've watched a few interviews with Taylor and Dave. And you know, there's one with George Strumpelopoulos from Canada. If you don't know that name, it's going to sound very weird, but Strombo for short. But anyway, a guy, he was Canadian. He is Canadian. He's still in the music scene, you know, interviewing people. But anyway, and I love him. Anyway, but yeah, he was there, and they were talking about, you know, how Because there was a song on the album from 2000, their 2005 album, In Your Honor, I think it was. I want to say it was what it's called. But it was called Let It Die, I think it was. And it's just, I haven't listened to the song. I apologize. But they talked about how, you know, it sounds like it's about Kurt and Courtney. And then Dave talks about, you know, it's just, you know, when you write a song like that, you know, you're going to be, you know, you're going to know you're going to get the question is like, is this about Kurt? And he talked about, you know, I've lost so many people in my life. But it's always about Kurt. And then, I mean, so I think about that. And now it's going to be, you know, Kurt and Taylor. And I mean, he's lost so many people in his life. But yeah, it's just like when, you know, when it's so public and it's just like you lost your, you know, you lost your two best friends in your bands that you've, you know, in your bands, you know, Kurt and freaking Taylor. It's just like, I don't know. So yeah, anyway, all that rambling aside, it sucks that he lost two of his best friends and two of his, you know, musical friends. I mean, it's just like they created beauty together. And now just talking about Taylor, yeah, they created so much beauty. And I mean, the Foo Fighters, it's just like, I've heard before, you know, people say that, like, I've heard, you know, people say that the Foo Fighters singles are always so, like, good. And it's just like, it seems like they put so much effort into the singles. It's just like, they have so many good songs. It's just like, you know, you think of, again, how Dave said here, you know, an up-tempo Foo Fighter song. You think of songs that are, like Walk or, you know, These Days. It's just like, they're so uplifting. And it's just like, I just love that that's the style that they always wanted to kind of go with. And I mean, I think of, you know, a more recent song, I think from like 2017, you know, The Sky is a Neighborhood. It's just, it doesn't matter, you know, or even their, you know, their recent album, which I can't remember the name of, but I'll probably insert here. But I heard a few songs off that one as well. And it's just like, I don't know, they always have the same sound, the same style. And it's just like, it doesn't matter. It's just like, you know, you're going to find at least one or two songs off of a Foo Fighters album that's just going to stick with you. And, anyway, you know, all the stuff, basically, I just want to say, rest in peace, Taylor Hawkins. Like I said before there, I've said it, you know, 1,000 ways now, but it just sucks that he's gone, sudden, and, you know, seeing so many musicians talk about it, you know, Tom Morello and Guns N' Roses, but yeah, Slash and Axl, I've seen, like I said, Brian Wilson, I saw, you know, somebody, obviously Perry Farrell from Jane's Addiction, you know, so many people have come out to talk about Taylor, and I'm sure, you know, there's way more people than who I just mentioned, but yeah, it's just like, it's just nuts. But anyway, thanks for watching, I guess I'll say, thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, really appreciate all the support, and yeah, this video was just very long, and me talking a lot, but I just wanted to, you know, say things about Taylor Hawkins, because they've been on my mind, and you know, it's just, yeah, it's just nuts that he's gone. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys again soon.